Coming up, I'll walk you through all the steps as an admin to assess and migrate your client virtual machines and their related dependencies to Azure using Azure Migrate. Azure Migrate is a central hub to discover, assess, and migrate workloads to Azure. It provides tooling and monitoring for both Microsoft and partner migration services for moving servers, databases, websites, and virtual desktop infrastructure to the cloud. You can find more at aka.ms/Azure Migrate. Now today I'm going to focus on the steps used for migrating your virtual desktop infrastructure. Now when migrating VDI, there are two primary paths. You can either migrate your existing host infrastructure to new Windows Virtual Desktop host infrastructure on Azure and tailor your VDI images that you already have to the new environment. And this is great for shared virtual machines. Or you can also choose to replicate existing persistent virtual machines on the new infrastructure, which really works well for user-dedicated personal VMs. In both scenarios, Azure Migrate provides the tools to support your migration, even helps you when you need to migrate dependent apps and services that are running in your server VMs. And if you saw our last how-to for Azure Migrate for migrating servers at aka.ms/mechanics/Azure Migrate, that process to migrate persistent client VMs shares many of the same steps. So first, we're going to set up the prerequisites, and then next, we'll set up Azure Migrate. Then we'll discover the different VMs and their composition and how they're being used. Then you'll review the assessment, and if you're bringing over persistent VMs, you'll replicate them, then test your migration, and finally migrate them to production. Now this process will use the same Azure Migrate server migration tool for replication, testing, and the production migration, which also works for client operating systems. And to save time, I'll focus on what's different from the client OS perspective. And if you're migrating infrastructure and tailoring or building new images for Windows Virtual Desktop, the assessment tool from Lakeside will give you all the information needed to make any necessary changes to your images or build new ones based on detailed inventory and usage information that it provides. We'll also cover the process to convert user profile disks or UPDs to FS Logics and add WVD components to your base images. So let's get started. First, you'll need an Azure subscription, and if your organization already has one, you'll need to make sure that you have the right level of permissions. Now, this also extends to service provisioning, networking, storage, and of course, virtual machine creation, among other services. Next, we're going to head over to Azure Migrate. Now, the best way to get there is from the Azure portal's homepage is just to go down to Useful Links and Azure Migration Tools. Now, once you're here, you're going to see options for migrating Windows and Linux servers, migrating SQL and other databases, or exploring more scenarios, which is where you'll see VDI as well as web app migration. Now to get started with VDI, I'm gonna go ahead and click into VDI. Then I'll click on to add tools. And this is gonna walk us through a wizard-based process to select assessment and migration tools. So in the first step that you see here, select assessment tool, we're gonna see Lakeside SysTrack. Now Lakeside is a Microsoft partner that specializes in assessing and migrating VDI environments. Now, its SysTrack solution supports Microsoft RDS, VMware, Citrix, and even physical devices to help with a readiness assessment, app usage analysis, and to make sure that we can discover, prioritize, and migrate dependent apps, as well as right-sizing a virtual machine infrastructure for Windows Virtual Desktop. So now I've got it selected, I'm going to go ahead and click Next to the next step. So that's where we're going to see our migration tool. And as I mentioned earlier, this is going to be Azure Migrate server migration. Again, that supports client operating systems. So it works with VMware, Hyper-V, as well as physical machines and can be used with on-premises or other clouds. Now it's going to replicate VMs and also allow test migration and ultimately migrate or cut over your production workloads into Azure. So I've already got this selected, so I just have to hit Next and Continue. Here I can see all of my selections and I'll click Add Tools. And now I've got my tools selected. I'm ready to start assessing my current infrastructure. This is easily the most important phase if you're going to be using shared VMs and standard images. And I want to point out a few unique considerations when moving your VDI environment to Azure. Now here, we'll assess quite a few different aspects across our hosts and our VM host pools, or for personal VMs that are assigned to individual users. Now, the assessment from Lakeside is going to help you gather this information. The first thing you need to do is click into Register for Azure Migrate. That's going to actually log you in and then create that connection, that linkage between Azure Migrate and your Lakeside dashboard. Then you'll be able to track discovered users that are ready for migration within Azure Migrate. Now, importantly here, you're going to have to deploy agents to your virtual machines as packages. Now you can use your standard software distribution tools, things like Configuration Manager, and once those agents are installed and configured, they'll start logging up performance and inventory data, among other things, into the Lakeside portal. So in Lakeside's SysTrack Visualizer, you'll see once I click from desktop into persona, it's done a lot of work here in terms of looking at average CPU utilization, memory, IOPS, and it's even segmented the different user types to deskbound, non-deskbound, and shared users. So we see quite a bit there. Now, if we go into resource consumption for users, we'll be able to see how each user and how each virtual machine is actually consuming resources in our inventory. So all the different critical things there to make decisions around things like VM sizing, for example. Now, additionally, beyond all of this, you can go back into desktop and check out all the rest of the aspects of your virtual machines, for example, applications. So here you get a full inventory of all the applications that it gets discovered in your environment, but even more importantly for VDI is looking at things like application latency. So you can look at the considerations around in-house network resources that you're going to need to decide with all of this, what you're going to move, what maybe to bring with you into Azure, as well as what you might be able to leave behind in your current on-premises VDI infrastructure. So one tip here, for internal network paths and even connecting your on-prem domain controllers, you're going to need to establish a virtual network or VNet between your internal network and the VM resources and services that you're going to be running in Azure. Additionally, depending on the usage needs for your in-house hosted apps, you'll want to consider migrating your app servers up into the cloud, also using Azure Migrate. That will get them closer to your desktop VMs that are running in Azure. So let's go back to our assessment. So here, you can also see under resource consumption, you can see things like CPU percentage, memory percentile, and also IOPS and networking consumption. Now, Lakeside also provides a rating for individual user experience that you can check pre and post migration for benchmarking. Now, the tool also logs much of that collected information back into Azure Migrate. So here, I'm going to click on Discovered Users. When I click in there, you'll see that we've got information on user accounts, their devices, total applications used, the operating system that's used. If it's a shared Windows Server OS, for example, that will show up as well. Also their persona, the target VM size, and even the target location. Now, another tip here for Windows Virtual Desktop, you're gonna need to synchronize your Active Directory with Azure AD. Now, if you use Office 365 right now, chances are you already have done this, and Azure AD is used to authenticate into the remote desktop apps as well as the WVD web portal. But then when you access virtual desktops or apps, the authentication for those sessions is performed via your domain controller, which is usually either another virtual machine that runs in Azure or Azure Active Directory domain services in Azure. Now, in most cases, you won't be bringing your existing standard images as is, completely as they are right now, from your current VDI environment. The details from the Lakeside assessment is going to help you inform how to compose your desktop images, including approaches for provisioning applications, security components and controls, how they connect to services, and also matching appropriate desktop and app resources to end users based on their current usage patterns. Next, you'll need to set up your Windows Virtual Desktop instance in Azure. Now here you'll start by creating a host pool. So you do that by going through the standard process. You'll see kind of the familiar fields around the name, some of the aspects around who's using it. Then if I want to customize the virtual machines, I can do that here. I'll give that a number of virtual machines I want to have within my host pool. And I can select either from an image that I've imported into Azure Blob Storage, or I can choose to use an image from the gallery, which I'll do in this case. From there, I can look at the parameters and create my host pool. Now, one note here is that WVD is optimized for FSLogic's user profiles and doesn't support other forms of user profile disks. But you can convert user profile disks to FSLogic's profiles using PowerShell. That converts the disks and also places it into the correct shared location in Azure. And to do this, you need to get to the FSLogic's migration preview module for PowerShell at aka.ms/FSLogic's migration preview module. And here you can also see the sample syntax for both UDP conversion as well as roaming profile conversion. One note is that you'll need to have the modules loaded for Hyper-V, Active Directory, and Pester to run these commands. Now, if you're using personal VMs, one dedicated per user, and client operating systems, you might want to start by looking into moving to Windows 10 Enterprise Multi-Session. This option is unique to WVD and can give you the same compatibility and user experience of a dedicated VM using a client OS, but the resource utilization benefits of a shared operating system, which until now was only a server option. Now that means that depending on your VM specs and usage, your users might actually benefit from more powerful compute while reducing your overall infrastructure costs. Now when you combine this with FSLogic's user profiles and app layering using MSIX app attach, shared VMs feel dedicated to your users, but each time they log in, their user profile and apps will dynamically get assigned instantly and provide a consistent experience regardless of which VM they're assigned to in a host pool. If your primary use case is moving the underlying virtual desktop infrastructure to Azure using new or standard images, your work now in Azure Migrate is done. Now you need to do the rest of the work in the WVD admin experience. And if you haven't looked at this since WVD's initial launch in September 2019, we've delivered a comprehensive set of controls in the new WVD admin center. This is where you're going to provision most of the aspects of the service, the host pools I showed you earlier, as well as your users, workspaces, and application groups. Plus, any considerations for managing user profiles via FSLogix or app delivery via MSIX app attach. Now, if you're looking to move persistent and dedicated personal VMs into Azure, then we'll continue using the migration tool that we selected earlier with Azure Migrate Server Migration. Now, in this process, just like with migrating servers, you're going to first set up an appliance VM in your environment that's going to manage the replication. Next, you'll target the host that you want to replicate into Azure Blob Storage. Then, once you're done replicating, virtual machines will continuously replicate into Azure until you're ready to test and migrate those VMs into production. Now, for either migration type, after your virtual machines are running in Azure, you'll need to install and configure the WVD agent, which you can get from aka.ms/WVD VM agent. Let me show you what that looks like. So here, after we run it, we'll click Next. We'll see our licensing terms. Now here's where it's going to ask for a registration token. Now we have to use PowerShell to export that from our host pool and our tenant running WVD. Once we do that, that will create a text file with your registration token. You'll copy that and then insert that value here into the agent. Then I'll click Next, and that will basically connect that virtual machine running in Azure to your WVD environment and host pool. The agent is packaged as an MSI, and you can pass in your reg token as a parameter when automating the process as shown here using MSI exec commands. Now the final step is to match those VMs to users and assign them to the people that are using them prior to the migration. You'll see as I do that here, I'm just going to go into the WVD admin portal, click on users, then we'll search for the users or groups. In my case, I'll just click on accountants, and here I'll see the assignments that I've already got prepared for them in one host pool. And I can add another host pool, for example, here with work apps and 0224.hp, that's going to then apply a new host pool, maybe from the VMs that I just imported. So remember, as with any migration, it's usually best to start out with just a few hosts and users, then scale your deployment out as you master the tools and processes. So that was an overview of the IT admin steps needed to assess and migrate your virtual desktop environments to Windows Virtual Desktop hosted on Azure. Now check out aka.ms/WVD playlist for even more information on Windows Virtual Desktop and all of your options. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.